Hi, welcome to MooMooMath. Today we're going to talk about one of my favorite theorems, and that is the Pythagorean Theorem. And the formula is a squared plus b squared equals c squared. So let's look at a triangle and what this applies to. Okay, we have to have a right triangle to apply the Pythagorean Theorem, where the two legs, or the shorter two sides, are a and b. So A and B are the two short sides, or the short legs, of the right triangle. And the hypotenuse, C, is opposite the right angle. So here's our example. If we have the legs of 6 and 8, what is C, or the hypotenuse? And we're going to work that out in just a second, but let's look at the formula in a little more detail and look at the rules. Okay, the rules are as follows. A and B are always the legs. C is always the hypotenuse. How do you work the formula? Where it's very simple. You square A, so that's where we get the A squared, and you square B, that's the B squared part. Then we add those two together, so we add A squared plus B squared. Then we take the square root of that number, so we take the sum, square root of the sum of those two, and we have the Pythagorean Theorem. So A and B are always the legs, and C is the hypotenuse. Let's run through this example. Okay, 6 and 8 are both legs. So I'm just going to arbitrarily say that 6 is A and 8 is B. These can actually interchange. It doesn't really matter. A squared, or 6 squared, plus B squared, which is 8 squared, is equal to, don't forget to square the C down here. Okay, so we have 36 plus 8 squared is 64. And that's equal to C squared. The sum of these is 100 is equal to C squared. And to undo a square, we have to square root that sum. And so we get the answer of 10. And there you go. That's how you work the Pythagorean Theorem.